the inner cities, parents walking with their beautiful child, and they get shot. They're shot. Their child is shot, often killed. Folks, what do you have to lose?
To those hurting and suffering and left behind, I say, what do you have to lose by trying something new? What do you have to lose by voting for Donald Trump for president? You can go to war zones in countries that we're fighting, and it's safer than living in some of our inner cities. They're run by the Democrats. What the hell do you have to lose? Give me a chance. I'll straighten it out. I'll straighten it out.
But according to a recent NBC online tracking poll, only 8% of black voters and 22% of Hispanic voters support Trump. And of course, he's making these pitches in front of nearly all white audiences while avoiding opportunities to speak directly to communities of color. Today, Hillary Clinton released an ad criticizing Trump's approach.
I have a great relationship with the blacks. I've always had a great relationship with the blacks.
What the hell do you have to lose?
For more, I'm joined by Sean Jackson, Trump supporter and chairman of the Republican Caucus of Florida, and Hector Sanchez, chairman of the National Hispanic Leadership Agenda. Gentlemen, thank you for being here. And Sean, I want to start with you. You're from Florida. I lived in Florida for quite a long time. Would you consider the majority of black communities to be essentially urban hellholes, the way Donald Trump has described them?
Well, Joy, with all due respect, I don't think you can say that Mr. Trump has classified all black communities as quote-unquote urban hellholes. But it is apparent that whenever you go into inner cities across Florida, and I myself was born and raised in the inner city, specifically in West Palm Beach, Florida, you can see a lot of blight. And the sad part about it is, you know what, a lot of municipalities like that have cities, areas and within cities like that, such as West Palm Beach, are all democratically ran municipalities. So Mr. Trump has a very valid point.
Well, let me ask you this question. Do you think that saying, I mean, he has really only talked about communities of color as being places that are hellscapes in his description. You get shot, you can't walk down the street. He's made it sound like there's really no good taking place in urban communities. You yourself have had some challenges with the way the Trump campaign has outreached to black voters in Florida. You were ushered out of a Donald Trump rally or not allowed to be backstage. You've said on the record that you felt that his campaign manager in Florida doesn't know anything about black outreach, doesn't care about it. Are you saying that the Trump outreach effort makes sense?
So let's be clear, Joy, I was not ousted out of the Trump rally, number one. And number two, there's nothing uncommon about anyone, whether it be in a Trump campaign or a Clinton campaign for that matter, having differences of opinions with various staffers. Yes, I had a difference of opinion at one point with a senior staffer. However, she and I work very well and very closely together to make sure that we do deliver the black vote for Mr. Trump in November.
That's interesting. That's different from what you've been saying about that outreach effort in the past. You recently told the Miami New Times, this is your quote, I've been saying repeatedly that you cannot go into a black community in the ninth hour of a campaign and ask them to vote for a GOP candidate. You have to have a vested interest in time and in your financial effort for the whole campaign, not just the last 100 days. Have you changed your mind about
that? You're absolutely right. And Mr. Trump has a very clear and concise vested interest in the black community. Hence the reason why you hear him talking so much about how he wants to go into inner city communities that have all of the blight and the crime, as you mentioned.
How come he hasn't done so? He's been running for president for a year. He's only speaking in front of white audiences.
Joy, he's in the process of doing that now, just like Hillary Clinton is in the process of refuting everything that Mr. Trump says by trying to make him out to be the bigot. The truth of the matter is, when Mr. Trump made it clear that she was a bigot, you know what?
You think she's a bigot? You think Hillary Clinton's a bigot?
Is that the word that I would use? Probably not. However, her tendencies over the years have aligned up with the phrase bigot.
So you think that Hillary Clinton is a bigot? In your view,
I said that. Joy, I said that the things that she has done in her 27-year career as a politician have aligned up with that term, bigot.
That's very interesting. All right, so you're on board with Donald Trump's basically description of Hillary Clinton as a bigot. Hector
Sanchez. What I am on board with is the fact that Hillary Clinton has called black men super predators, and Hillary Clinton has worked alongside with her husband, Bill Clinton, to incarcerate more black men in the history of any other law in this nation's history. That's what I'm on board with.
Let me get Hector Sanchez in. I'm sorry. I want you to get in as well, Hector.
Yeah, no, thank you for the invitation, Joanna. Sure. Let me start by saying that we have a very serious concern as a community with these constant attacks on Latinos and immigrants in the nation, all this constant bigotry towards our community. And it's because it's having a real impact in our community. Bullying against our children in schools is increasing. Hate crimes against Latinos in the nation is increasing. Racial profiling against Latinos is increasing in the nation. So we can see that all this rhetoric and all these attacks on our community are really affecting and increasing the vulnerability of our families in the nation. So we are asking and we are demanding candidate Trump to stop the attacks on our community and come to the table, meet with us. He really wants to meet with the most important Latino leaders in the nation. He really wants to discuss real policy priorities. The table, a nonpartisan table, the National Hispanic Leadership Agenda is open. We invite him to come here. We invite him to tell us where he stands on all the policy priorities that we have in our public policy agenda here on the NHLA, and that's where we want to take this discussion. We're very concerned about his takes on immigration. What are his takes on immigration? Build a wall, deport all the 11 million undocumented workers. Well, let me tell you what I know about those 11 million undocumented workers. Entire sectors of the economy depend on the hard work of these families. I have seen and I have witnessed the conditions of these farm workers. I have witnessed and seen the conditions in the hotels, in the factories, and the different industries that depend on these hard workers. So when they say that they are stealing jobs from other people, I say nobody should work under those horrible conditions where constant violation of labor rights, human rights, and civil rights are constantly happening. So it's time to come to the table. It's time to have real, solid policy discussions. And it's time to really win the Latino vote. We are inviting all the campaigns to discuss and come to talk to us. Some of the campaigns have been extremely responsive and engaged in all the process.
And you haven't had that. Let me ask you this real quick question, Hector. You know, George W. Bush did actually quite well. He got 44% of the Latino vote. And you only had 22% among the Hispanic community, or 27% for Mitt Romney. How much damage do you think, very briefly, that Donald Trump is doing with Hispanic voters with the rhetoric that you've described?
It's a very clear damage. As I say, his rhetoric has had a serious negative impact in our community. But it's the beauty of democracy. We invite all the presidential candidates to engage with us. We need for them to understand what are the policy priorities of the Latino community in the nation. So we invited the Clinton campaign. They responded. Senator Clinton came and met with us. They responded to their questionnaire. We're asking Trump to come and meet with us to discuss and understand our policy priorities.
Sure.
We also asked him to respond to our questionnaire that we're going to release to the Latino board.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.